Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Mohid Rifai and today I will report the analysis of the 2013 English curriculum for vocational high schools in Indonesia. The object of the analysis is the 2013 English curriculum for vocational high schools in Indonesia. Why? Because I see that the need of the SMK students for English education is different from what their peers have in SMA. Now, for the rationale, the learning theory that underpins this curriculum is the social learning theory. This can be seen from the statement in the curriculum that the learning processes are conducted on the basis of activities which are interactive, inspiring, fun, challenging, and motivating to the students. So from this statement, we can see that it is in line with what Bandura stated, that the production of experiences is gained through controlling one's motivation and activities. And for the teaching approach, it can be seen from the competency that the focus of English curriculum is to use English effectively in everyday life and related to the field of expertise. So from this statement, we can see that the focus is to use English. So just according to Fauziati in 2015, that the genre-based analysis is the study of how the language is used in particular setting. So we can conclude that this teaching approach has underpinned the curriculum of the English curriculum for SMK. Now for the teacher role, Snow and Campbell in 2017 argued that there are two different types of teacher roles. The first one is the SAGE model and the second one is the COACH model. If we see the curriculum, we can see that teachers develop the students' potential, initiative, and autonomy according to their interest and innate capability and psychological development. So from this statement, we can see that the teacher do not only deliver knowledge, but also they also develop the students' potential, initiative, and autonomy. So we can conclude that the teacher role is follows the SAGE, the COACH model, is proposed by Snow and Campbell 2017. And the last one, model and types. The development model of this curriculum is Tyler's deductive model. According to Lanemets and Kalamis Rubel in 2013, the deductive model of Tyler's deductive model let the administrators design the curriculum and teachers implement it. We can see this from the statement here, the competency standard of SMK grade are developed from the aim of the national education. So we can see that the development started from the top to the bottom or top down. We can also call it the deductive model. In addition to that, the 2013 curriculum adheres to taught curriculum and learned curriculum. These are the types of the curriculum in the 2013 curriculum. Now the curriculum ideologies, there are five curriculum ideologies that are underpinned this curriculum as proposed by Richards 2001. The first one is educationalism. We can see it from the aim of the curriculum that the curriculum is aimed at developing intellectual intelligence and academic brightness. And then the next one is cultural pluralism. It is mentioned that the curriculum is developed based on the diversity of Indonesian culture. And learner-centeredness. From the statement, we can see that the enforcement of learner-centered learning pattern is the basis of the development of this curriculum. And then the social reconstructionism. It is mentioned that the curriculum is aimed at developing the learner's potential into the ability for reflective thinking to solve social problems. And then for the last one, social economic efficiency, we can see it from the aim of the vocational high school education that they are aimed at comprehending the competencies needed in the current time and in the future. Now the result analysis. For the aim, it was stated that the purposes of the aim of the curriculum is to use English effectively in everyday life and related to their field of expertise. You can see clearly that the focus of this aim is to use English. And more specifically, there are three basic competencies here: understand, comprehend, and analyze information, evaluate the linguistic content, and creatively compose a new text. So from this statement of aims, we can see that the statement of aims are in line with what Richards and Brown stated that the statement of aims should focus on the change in the learners. And then for the content, you can see here that the content has various content, but three of which you can see that the first one, polite spoken and written English to communicate and collaborate with speaking partners in the context of work, culture, and working situation. This implies that the Industry 4.0 skills is proposed by this curriculum, which include collaborating, communicating, creativity, and critical thinking. And then short and simple text, authentic and semi-authentic for practical use based on the field of expertise with clear and reliable sources. We can see from this content that the content promoted ESP, or English for specific purposes. And the last one, elements of intellect and ingenuity, sharpen critical thinking hearts, as well as reading habituation literacy skills in various expertise. From this statement, it is explicitly stated that HOTS, or higher thinking skill, is one of the elements of intellect in the curriculum. So we can see that it is in line with what Debbie Yanka stated, that the young adolescents has to have the ability to use the higher thinking skills processes. And then the last one, evaluation. In evaluation, the assessment purposes are to know the level of students' learning competency or achievement, to know the growth and development of the students, to diagnose the students' learning difficulties, to know the effectiveness of the learning process, and to know the curriculum accomplishment. This is in line with what was stated by Tyler, that the evaluation should determine how far the learning experience is produced the expected result. However, the curriculum seemed to miss one point, which is the effectiveness of the teacher. And lastly, for the recommendation and conclusion recommendation, from the discussion we can see that the curriculum has met most of the needs. However, the misimplementation of the curriculum is still a problem. Therefore, the curriculum needs to set the aim to determine the effectiveness of the instrument of the curriculum, including teachers and other conditions that was involved in the implementation of the curriculum. Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.